Hey, Paul.
Hey.
How's it going?
I'm good.
I heard that there's this awesome Helix pedal.
Yeah, so we kind of started off with you saying that Line6 don't really do bass stuff.
Okay.
And in some ways, you're sort of right. However, you can use the brand new, like the Helix, for all kinds of bass stuff as well.
Okay.
So it has a range of bass models in there, a range of bass cabinet models. It has all kinds of effects that you can use with bass as well. And then obviously, as I think we were just talking about earlier, that now part of the Yamaha group is that we have Ampeg amps, so you can now have a Yamaha bass into a Helix, use the effects, use the preamps, the bass preamps in here, and then run it into an Ampeg stack as well. But we don't have an Ampeg stack today, so.
That's okay. So next video.
So, I mean, maybe I just go through a little bit of what's in here. I mean, there's a lot of guitar amplifiers in there, so we've got like 77 different amps, I think, in there.
Jesus.
But there's 13 different bass amps, so there's everything from Ampeg sort of classics. There's the there's Mesa Boogie bass amps in there as well. Billy Sheehan uses a Helix for all his bass. Well, a lot of his bass stuff, his live stuff as well, so mm-hmm. there's a model of his Pierce preamp that he always uses. And then we've got things like the Sun, you know, the big Sun Coliseum, and we've got the acoustic, you know, the Jacko style bass amp in there as well. So I mean, maybe if I just kind of go through how this works on the actual screen. So this is your bass guitar coming in here.
Okay.
And at the moment, we've only added one different thing in here, and I've chosen to have. One of the beauties of the Helix is how easy it is to use. So I'm going to use this joystick here, and I can just drop anything in that chain that I wanted to have there. So the bass is coming in. I've selected, by pressing that in, I've selected the bass preamps. So I've scrolled down. This is work I did just before we started the video. Uh-huh. Scroll down to bass preamps. Obviously, I could have electric guitar preamps, but let's go back in and do that. So preamp, bass, and then there we have all those different bass. There. And we're at the moment we're running this just straight into the effects return of this Mark bass.
Yeah.
Yep. So you're just hearing none of the EQ or anything on that's working. So if we go through those, something like the Cali bass.
Nice and fat.
And then I can scroll through those and this is just now bass preamp. So now we have different channels of a Mesa Boogie Bass 400 Plus.
Oh my god. Channel 2. Yeah.
Galleon Kruger?
Yeah, that's what I use.
So I mean, let's continue going through some of those sounds and maybe add some effects to that. We need some harmonics and neck bending.
Oh, Jesus!
That channel's a bit louder. Yeah, and then we've got things like studio tube preamps and things as well. If you were using this sort of directly in the PA system on a recording system,
yep.
We've also got a range of cabinet models in there as well. So we've got sort of Ampeg 8x10s, and there's a 2x15 Mesa Boogie from the Bass 400 Plus. But obviously we have a cabinet, so I'm not adding those. But let's show how easy that would be. So if I did want to add a cabinet to that,
yeah.
So this will be so quick that you'd be able to do the next one. Everything's done with this joystick. So I'm going to press that in, just same as you saw me do before. I'm going to scroll down, and we said we wanted cabinet models. So we've got amp and cab, the preamps, which we're in currently. There's the cab, and then in here. So I probably wouldn't, it's not going to sound great with it through a real cab right now, but we should start to see at the top, at the bottom here, cabinets that match up with the acoustic amplifier, with the Sun Coliseum. 2x15 Brute is the, again, that was what the mono mentioned before for the Bass 400 Plus. And then you just press that, and now you've got a cabinet model. Bypass it. But let's say we want that preamp, and let's say we want to add some distortion maybe to the front of that. Do you use distortion when you play that?
It's at the front, yeah.
At the front, yeah. I was thinking that's quite unusual.
Yeah.
So I can go through here and I can choose, and we have some distortions in here, particularly for bass. Bit Crusher is the one that sounds broken. So it's a special effect. So it's the one that you don't want to pull out in a demo and try to win people.
Okay, fine.
But in a mix where you want things to sound different, it's great. But things like the Obsidian 7000 and the Clawthorn are actually bass, they're models of bass pedals
okay.
as well. Yeah, so I mean, are you going to try?
So, yeah. It's like a nice level of distortion on there.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna switch that off. Anyway, so now back to the preamp. Anything else that you'd have in the front? Maybe a compressor or compressor at the end?
Kind of anti-compressor. I like chorus pedals.
Okay, cool. So I'm gonna get you to do this. So
yeah.
Press that joystick.
That's good.
Scroll down. It's gonna be modulation.
Yeah, I knew that.
Yeah. We're in mono, so may as well stay mono, I guess. And then that's all your modulation pedals then. That's 194, I think, the current count is for the modulation.
Yeah,
not 194 modulations, 194 effects currently.
Let's go with the 70s chorus.
Yep.
Dope. Now if I want to tweak that, do I have access to...
So all the parameters are sitting at the bottom here.
Oh my god,
so
it'll change.
Six different parameters. And then you have a second page there as well. So you'll find that these parameters are the same as the original pedal.
Okay.
So.
Oh, and then there's even more parameters for you. I missed, would you push there? Okay, headphone.
Yes, it's just headphone.
Cool.
Okay. So let's leave that, but let's continue. So I'm gonna bypass that. Let's just start adding some different effects. Anything else?
What else do I use? Overdrive, but that's the same as distortion.
Bit of reverb at the end, maybe?
I would love to get a reverb.
Okay. Okay. So I'm gonna get you that, because it's so easy.
Yeah,
you know how to do it.
It's not hard at all. So, reverb. And mono. There we go.
I would probably, these are quite more extreme ones, so maybe go back over to the legacy.
Oh, it's a joystick.
It presses in, it turns around, and it does all kinds of things. Oh, all nice. Directions.
I like plate. It's my mixing stuff. I do like plate though. Let's try it. I've never had a plate on a... Okay, and that definitely needs to... less decay, maybe a little... So easy to use. Okay. I want one.
Okay. I'm going to go in here and I'm going to add an octave to the sound.
Yes.
So let's say we add just a simple pitch and then maybe just... So this chain now is the overdrive, it's the chorus, there's a pitch shifter there, it's a preamp, and then we have the reverb there, okay. So let's say now that you're building this bass rig that you want to take out. So this is where it starts to get really beautiful. So then we're gonna move over to the modulation, and I'm gonna assign the modulation to this pedal. Mm-hmm. So I actually just, I don't press the foot switch, I just touch it.
So it's got some sort of...
Hold it for 2 seconds, it's like mobile phone technology.
Okay.
Like, so capacitance, if you have gloves on, that won't work.
Yeah, okay.
So if you wear, like, when you put your gloves on for your gig, your Michael Jackson thing or whatever it is.
Using
the hand. And then I'm gonna quickly go through this again, and I'm gonna hold. Stay that on there, and then now I'm laying out all these different things. Super quick, ready to go to a gig, okay? So now, as you saw before, that parameters, 6 parameters there, have the 6 pots beneath them.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to, you know, measure, you know, change the, or tweak the obsidian there, mm-hmm. you touch that. There's all the parameters for that.
Right.
Touch the chorus. So there are no menu pages, there's no scrolling through different along menus and down through menus.
Yeah.
Everything is easily accessible straight away by doing clicking on there.
This thing is awesome, okay.
Yeah, and then you just click save. And that's it, that's your bass preamp and your effects all laid out.
Yeah.
So we've brought up the parameters here. Now in order to assign that to the pedal, it's mm-hmm. as easy as everything else I've shown you. So you press this down, the mix button. It says learn the controller.
Of course.
If you move that controller.
Boop. I think you have to press learn controller? Yeah, maybe I have to press that first and then.
Yes, I thought I'd done it.
Okay, on as max and min. Okay.
Yeah, so now you can see it's gone white. So now that's zero on that.
Jesus. Okay.
And you turn it. But let's say that you wanted to have maybe the chorus, and you wanted the mix of the chorus.
Yep. Okay. So you
to run at the same time, yeah. But this time, I actually wanted to have the chorus go from. So as the reverb goes up, the chorus is going to go down.
Ah.
Okay. So reverb goes up, but chorus starts at 75, and then I've actually returned that down as the pressure expression button. You can assign multiple things to that, so the EQ, compression, you know, whatever you want to do. So Whatever you want to do, it will do.
Apparently, yeah. That's amazing. Okay, that's great. Anything else that's like super unique that you want to talk about?
For bass players, that's 14 different or 13 different component models, you know, like 194 effects. So there's auto wires, there's all kind of, you know, we've been through a sort of range of them. Your guitar player can plug in as well, obviously, it's got all the guitar models on there. So it's great for running into an amp for a live situation. Mm-hmm. It's obviously a nice sturdy case as well. But if you want to record.
Oh, that's light.
If you want to record with it, you can do that as well, because on the back of this. So some of the features on the back here. So we've got XLR outputs, you have equipment outputs, the four different effects loops which are all assignable, the mic in that we talked about before. Mm-hmm. You can use it to channel change an amplifier, there's external amp switching jacks on there as well. Yeah. And then you've got USB, if you plug it into a Mac or a PC, it will work as a USB interface.
And will it be just stereo, or do you get the four inputs outputs also?
You really get a whole bunch of different stuff. So what you can also do is you can reamp with this as well. It all on USB channel 7, it always outputs the DI audio.
Okay.
So if you can reamp that, you know, through a real amp or whatever you want to do. So all kinds of things. So no, it's putting out quite a whole bunch of different stuff.
I've never seen this thing before.
So Variax is for. We used to have a Variax bass, but the Variax bass doesn't exist anymore. So we have a Variax guitar, which we have over in another room. This enables the guitar and Helix to talk to each other. And then with that, you can actually tune the guitar. You can like go to drop D tune, and you can tell the Helix will tell the guitar to change to a Telecaster, or to change to open D tuning, or to just maybe turn the B string up a minor third. And this is the interaction between the guitar, so that's what that's for, yeah.
Okay, cool.
So yeah, so there's a ton of stuff on there for guitar players, but it's obviously important to bass players are using these as well, you know, because there's a lot, all those effects are can be used with bass. There's bass specific effects. I know you don't like compressors, but the studio, the LA-2A model sounds really good.
If it comes built in, I'll definitely use it.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's kind of probably everything, yeah. Easy to use, sounds great.
What more can you want? That's great, thank you so much for showing me.
No problem.
Didn't even have to read a manual, that's glorious. thank you, Paul.
Okay, no problem, thank you very much.
Thanks for checking in.